The scale of this, the brutality, is truly unprecedented.
Completely unprecedented attack.
This is completely unprecedented here.
The conflict between Israel and the Palestinians is not new. In fact, it's been going on since before Israel's founding in 1948. So why is Hamas's latest attack on Israel so unprecedented? First, the surprise of the attack. On October 7th, Hamas launched a barrage of rockets towards Israel, while gunmen entered Israel from Gaza. Israel has not seen this kind of infiltration of military bases, towns, and kibbutzim in its 75-year history. The country is known for having one of the world's most impressive armed forces, a premier intelligence agency, and sophisticated border security, but this attack seemed to catch them off guard. The U.S. said they received no tactical-level intelligence that an attack of this size would happen on this day. A senior U.S. intelligence official told CNN that the capability of Hamas to coordinate attacks on Israeli towns without detection has raised concerns about technological blind spots for U.S. intelligence. Second, the intensity of the attack. Israel Defense Forces have said that more than 5,000 rockets have been launched from the Gaza Strip since October 7th. To put that into context, in 2021, during the 11-day war with Hamas, some 4,300 rockets were fired. Following Saturday's attack, Israel has formally declared war on Hamas, the first such declaration in 50 years, setting the stage for a major military operation in Gaza. Israeli forces are battling militants in southern Israel and have been pounding Gaza with airstrikes. By the conflict's third day, over 900 people were killed in Israel, while authorities in Gaza said over 680 people have been killed in the Palestinian enclave. On October 9th, Israel, which controls most of the importation of basic goods into Gaza, ordered a complete siege on the Palestinian enclave. No electricity, food, water, or fuel will be delivered there. Lastly, the hostage situation. Hamas says it is holding more than 100 hostages in Gaza. The group claims that this includes high-ranking army officers, but it also includes women, the elderly, and children. It's been more than 17 years since an Israeli soldier was taken hostage in an assault on the country's territory. Hamas says the hostages are now being held in locations across Gaza, which could complicate Israel's response to the militant group's deadly attack.